What's up, everybody? This is Scott from NoLifeTillMetal.com, and just got back from a workout at the gym, and then I went and gave some blood, and they put one of these wonderful pink things on my arm, and I thought, you know what? What a better time to listen to the men in pink, right? Real men wear pink. Everybody's favorite easy listening band, Twisted Sister! Okay, today I thought I'd share with my Twisted Sister vinyl collection with you. Huge Twisted Sister fan. I've been a Twisted Sister fan since I was in high school in the early 80s. And we'll just start from there. So Twisted Sister started in, was formed in 1972 by guitarist J.J. French, and played the club circuit for the New Jersey, New York, Connecticut area for years and years and years. By 1976, iconic frontman Dee Snider joined the band, and that's about time I'm going to pick up right here. So their very first single that they released was when I actually discovered the band. It would have been 1979, and the I'll Never Grow Up 45. Like I said, they couldn't get a record deal all through the 70s, so they decided to record their own single. They were selling out clubs all over the tri-state area and East Coast. It sold out to Palladium. They were they were breaking attendance records at some of the biggest clubs in the area. Yet, no record company was interested in them. It was just reject after reject. And they decided to record this first single. And a friend of mine in high school, I believe it was Tony Lee, guitar player for Heathen's Rage, who turned me on to this band. And it was this song right here, Under the Blade, the B side of this one, that we're like, that's awesome, heavy, raw, fast. Just Twisted Sister, early Twisted Sister, when they had that youthful energy, that that campiness from being in the clubs, almost a punk delivery. They weren't punk at all, but they just had that delivery to them, that it was just we don't care what you think about us delivery. So that was their first single, Under the Blade, first song that I heard from them, the first song that grabbed me and made me a fan. And from there I was on the search for this record, and it wasn't hard to find in that area during that time. And then the follow-up single, 1980, Bad Boys of Rock and Roll, backed with Ladies Boy. And this single, it was Ladies Boy that grabbed my attention. Again, the B-side. And that song is very, very campy, very different from Under the Blade. And it's on the Twisted Sister TSL, Twisted Sister label, TSR, excuse me, Twisted Sister Records. And so that was their first two singles, selling out clubs across the tri-state area, but they couldn't get a record deal. So in 1980-81, or somewhere around there, I believe it was, they packed it up and moved to England, where there was a budding new wave of British heavy metal scene that was just exploding. And the band scored a deal with a small underground label that no one had ever heard of, called Secret Records, and they released this EP. And myself and all my high school friends just ate this EP up, played it to death. I'm sure the needle wore a groove all the way through the other end on this one. We played it so much. Four songs, What You Don't Know, Shoot 'Em Down, Under the Blade, and a cover of Leader of the Pack. And this version of Leader of the Pack worked for the band. It was, they were still young and raw and hungry, and it was very campy, and it worked for them. It wasn't, the version that they would release later on down the road that would actually bite him in the butt. So anyhow, Rough Cuts, 1982, Secret Records. Oh, I don't want to show you the Secret Records label. It's the yellow Secret label. And then later on that year, they also released on Secret Records their full-length album, Under the Blade. And there's several different pressings of this, but I gotta say, before I say that, when this album came out, I was still young. I was still too young to get in the clubs. They were still playing the clubs in the area, and at one point, they played a club in New Jersey, maybe 20-minute bicycle ride from my house, and friend of mine from high school and myself, we went to a club and we couldn't get in, so we sat behind the club just so we could hear the boom, boom, boom of the band behind the club. Never did get to hear them. Never did get to see them during this period, though I would have loved to have. I was just too young to go to those, you know, those establishments. So, Under the Blade, Secret Records, 1982. Several different pressings of this one. There's a couple of them. This is on the Secret label. This is the black label version of it. And I can't remember which one's the original pressing. It doesn't really make a difference. There's several pressings of it. But this particular version of it, on the very last song on the B-side, when it gets to the Day of the Rocker, it just continues to spin. At the end of the record, so it's rock, 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 rock. And it never stops until you go and manually lift the needle up off the player. And then there's another pressing that's also on the Secret label. Same cover, same everything. But it has the original yellow and red Secret label. And that one does not have the, you know, the thing at the very end of the record. And here's the insert, lyric sleeve. Under the Blade, vicious, raw, heavy, a lot of very fast songs. Some slower songs like Destroyer, heavy, then had that little Mark Mendoza part that's on there. Destroyer! I mean, it was just heavy and raw. Unfortunately, after the band became popular later on down the road, the album was remixed in 1985, and Atlantic tried to capitalize on the band's fame and remixed the album. And basically took all the rawness away, which is what we liked about it, you know? It was that new wave of British heavy metal rawness. I mean, these guys were living in England at the time. They were part of that scene, even though they're American bands. You know, it was raw, like Motorhead, or the early Tigers of Pantang, or the very first Diamond Head, and all those albums had that heavy Raven, Venom. They had that raw, heavy rawness to it, and that's what this album had, that the remix just was, you know, just took all that away, and trying to make it a cleaner sound, and it was trying to capitalize on the, you know, the whole big hair metal of the mid-80s. They also added the single I'll Never Grow Up Now, which is not on the original pressing, but it is on this pressing. Of course, that was on the single I showed earlier. So, the band was just about to give it up. Secret Records went out of business. They couldn't get another record deal, and they made a couple last-ditch efforts. They played a TV show, and somehow Atlantic Records in Europe just liked them. One guy, I can't remember his name off the top of my head, but he brought it to Atlantic, said, "I'm signing you guys," and called the American counterparts, and they said, "You're nuts," but regardless, they signed, they recorded "You Can't Stop Rock and Roll." And this is the European pressing. I recorded the video for that song, and that video did fantastic. MTV used part of it for some commercial or something like that, and the song took off. The album took off. It wasn't massively popular, but it was popular enough where they were, you know, they were gaining momentum, and the label saw potential in them, and it was, of course, going to sink more money into them. And, this album still has that raw heaviness. It still has the fast songs, the heavy songs, the slow songs. And the Can't Stop Rock and Roll was actually an older song the band had written, you know, before they recorded Under the Blade. I have bootlegs of them playing that, you know, that song back in their club days. So, great song, probably one of their best. And then here is the American pressing, a little different, front and back cover, just a regular Atlantic label. And then this is the stuff that really just, I just loved this stuff. You know, if anybody would have asked me, what is your favorite Twisted Sister record? For me, Live at the Marquee. This series of singles that was released for You Can't Stop Rock and Roll. The Kids Are Back. But it wasn't the A side, it was the B side. What You Don't Know Sure Can't Hurt You. Bad Boys of Rock and Roll. Run For Your Life. Live at the Marquee. It was those songs. It was that. It was Twisted Sister on steroids. It was the raw energy of that stinky club with those people just packed in there, that crowd energy, feeding off the energy of the band. And then, of course, Dee Snider could whip any crowd into a frenzy, and his banter, in between song banter, is as entertaining as the songs are, and I loved this Marquee show. So, here was this one, and then there was the I Am On Me, backed with Tear It Loose, Destroyer, and You Can't Stop Rock and Roll, with the extended Dee Snider banter in the middle of the song, from the same Marquee show. And the I Am On Me 7-inch single with Sin After Sin live from the Marquee. And finally, the Kids Are Back 7-inch with Shoot 'Em Down live at the Marquee. And all these are just on the standard, you know, green and orange Atlantic label. As well, for this album, there was You Can't Stop Rock and Roll 7-inch with a B-side that included three songs, Let the Good Times Roll and Feel So Fine, excuse me, two songs, Feel So Fine, and a 12-inch with three songs. You Can't Stop Rock and Roll with Feel the Power, Four Barrel Heart of Love, and One Man Woman. And those three songs were recorded during the You Can't Stop Rock and Roll sessions, weren't on the album, but were released on this single. Easily as good as the songs on the album themselves. If they had been on the album, you know, they could have been on the album. They're just that good. So, essential single. These songs were released later on as bonus tracks on the CD version of the Can't Stop Rock and Roll. Okay, so we are in 1982. All those albums were released in 82, and sorry, 83. All of those albums were released in 1983, and the band was gaining momentum, so the label, of course, wanted to put more money into them, and they definitely did. Like I said, the video did well on MTV, who actually played music back then, and so they recorded their next album, and that album would be Stay Hungry. 1984. And this album, I gotta admit, when it first came out, I was still in high school, and I was a little disappointed. Not that it's a bad album, I actually have grown to love this album now, but when it first came out, you know, it was, didn't have the same power. And it's mostly the production, it doesn't have the rawness, doesn't have the edge that those first two albums had. There's still some dark, heavy songs on here, like the title cut, Burn in Hell, what else? The Beast, SMF. And of course, you know, Captain Howdy and Street Justice. But then there's also the songs that became huge MTV hits. I Wanna Rock and of course, We're Not Gonna Take It. Both those songs became huge on MTV with the videos. And of course, massive amounts of singles were released and they sold tons of records. And then here's the I Wanna Rock and Kids Are Back. Again, these are on the standard Atlantic label, all 1984, and finally, the single For the Price. Never seen a picture disc, but the picture sleeve of this one. Atlantic label. Yeah, they became huge, but the problem was they went from being, you know, this campy, heavy drag queen band that played in clubs to all of a sudden being a household name. And almost a cartoon of themselves, and that was due to those videos, overplay, massive radio play, massive MTV play, and they started becoming more appealing to kids than they were to the 20-somethings who were listening to, you know, the Motorheads and all those kind of bands at the time. There's a couple more singles, 12-inch singles for We're Not Gonna Take It, back with live versions of The Kids Are Back, Can't Stop Rock and Roll, and We're Gonna Make It. That was the thing about Twisted Sister at the time. It was all about we're gonna make it, we're gonna make it. You can't stop us, you can't stop rock and roll. And once they made it, they didn't know what to do with it. So this is the I Wanna Rock with Burn Hell and SMF Live, 12-inch single. And finally, this album was also re-released in 2009, I believe, on 180-gram vinyl. And it was very faithful to the original release, with even releasing the sleeves just the way it was released the first time. Lyrics, band photos. But it was released on Pepto-Bismol Pink Vinyl. And the re-release also came with a poster. poster is a little odd because it's not actually from the, it's not a Photoshop shoot from this album, but it's actually from the next album, but still nice to have the poster. Stay Hungry, 180 Gram. So after that, they were, you know, they had made it, they were huge, and they were trying to, instead of thinking about making it now, they had made it, and they were like, okay, what's going to be our next single? How do we top what we did last time? And what they tried doing was, Come Out and Play, 1985. And this album sold real well at first, but this is where the cover of, I forgot the name of the cover on the top of my head now. Leader of the Pack, where Leader of the Pack was released as a single and it came back to bite him, because it was no longer campy, it was no longer, you know, fun, it was schlocky, and even the video was just schlocky, it wasn't fun anymore, it wasn't, you know, it just didn't have the same vibe, and then the sound, the recording, it was very, didn't have the rawness, it was very with the times, very poppy. A lot of the American hair bands had that very clean sound that was, I don't know, almost slick and overproduced, and that's exactly what happened with Come Out and Play. It's not a bad album. I still like it. There's still some great songs on here, but unfortunately, it didn't do well for the band. They had this big, major production for a big, huge tour they were going to do, and from what I know, the tour tanked, and the band just began to disintegrate at that point. But before completely disintegrating, I guess I should show the singles for that one too. So there was You Want What We Got single, 85, Atlantic Records, and the Leader of the Pack US single with I Wanna Rock on the B-side, just the regular studio version. And then here's the European edition of that same single, which is a gatefold. And, you know, it has, of course, the Atlantic label, but it also included a poster, which I will try to get out of the package. So, yeah. Leader of the Pack, I Wanna Rock, 1985 single, 45. So anyhow, after that, they released, I guess Dee was planning on doing a solo album, but the record company wanted a Twisted Sister record, so they band recorded, yes, Love Is For Suckers. Great album cover, very cool, very sexy, like the lollipop with a TS on it, but it didn't sound like Twisted Sister anymore. Now it sounded like all the other bands coming out of LA, Hollywood, in the 80s. Very clean, very poppy, so it was no longer Twisted Sister leading the pack. It was now Twisted Sister following the pack. And it's still some good songs on him. Wake Up the Sleeping Giant, awesome song. Great song, and one that they've resurrected live over the last decade, and I'm glad they have, because it's a great song. But the single from the album was Hot Love, and here's the single for that one, 7-inch single. It's a good song too, but it's very poppy. It doesn't have the raw energy of the music you hear in the background. So anyhow, that's almost all my vinyl. I forgot one. I'm gonna go grab it and be right back. There you go. Twisted Sister live at the Hammersmith. this album was actually released in 1994 on CD only, but it was released a couple years ago on vinyl for the first time, and it's on 180 gram thick vinyl, but it's this pink, purple, lavender color with custom labels. And it's a gatefold. And this album was recorded at the beginning of the Stay Hungry tour, and the band was still hungry. They hadn't quite made it yet, so there's still all that, you know, Dee Snider tough talk on stage about making it and just whipping the crowd into a frenzy. So it's a great show. Features, you know, some of the best songs from Stay Hungry. It features songs from Under the Blade, You Can't Sleep Rock and Roll. It's a classic live record. And it also has a few songs from the club days, the Jailhouse Rock and Train Kept a Rollin'. Train Kept a Rollin' has been recorded by like just about every band I can think of. Aerosmith, Motorhead, Yardbirds. Great song, but anyhow. So yeah, that's it. Twisted Sister, my vinyl collection. I hope you enjoy it. I'd like to send a big shout out to all my friends in the BC. Appreciate you guys. Thanks for all the discussion we've been having on YouTube and off YouTube. And that's it. So God bless and stay strong. Twisted Sister. Dang it! Chair moved.